for a berth in the AFC Championship game. Off we go in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it. So those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
And they still need 8 yards for the first here on second down. They'll send a receiver in motion left. Now a handoff here to his running back. Up there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short.
Gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Second down following the run. Switch it up here and look to throw. And he'll be hit from behind and taken down. They were able to win last week despite him being sacked 4 times. They might need to tighten the reins a little bit, or this one may not end in another victory.
You're right about that. They can't count on just winning the game no matter what happens. They can't let the accumulation of hits and harassment in the pocket get to their quarterback. Got to stop that. Give him clean lanes to throw the football in order to have a better chance to win again this week.
And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long.
Here we go.
Halfback sent in motion. Oh, and they sent the man in motion too late. This is going to be a delay.
Go, 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 go.
He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that, because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
And following that penalty, the offense really backed up now on third down. Set up to throw. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
Black Brown! Black Brown! Here we go! Ohio! Ohio!
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he's gonna get this one down to the 45. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
See if they stay on the ground for second down.
Here we go.
They'll send a receiver in motion to the left. They're going to look to throw. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46. The seventh play now of this opening drive. This is third and long, though.
Here we go. Grand back down.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Too great, and he goes down once more.
I remember when I was a kid, and all I wanted was a nickel so I could get that soda down at the fountain. And guess what? The nickel came into play well. 5 defensive backs, they covered well, allowed for the sacks.
Sodas were a nickel when you were a kid?
No, I just needed the extra nickel so I could pay the, proper price.
Okay, how much were they, a dime? What were they?
15 cents.
And the punt team on now as this one set away. Taken in at the 11. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Tuck it and run. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Clock winding down. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Yates. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. 12 yards there as they move the chains. Down. Throw left side complete. It's Sparks. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. The completion good for 3 and it's second down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there? Swarming to it and not allowing that to happen. Did not let him get downfield.
Drop to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. So a first quarter sack, and remember, keep in mind, he had 2 sacks in last week's game.
And it's always intriguing to me to watch these great pass rushers because some of them, they need their teammates to scheme for them, maybe occupy people and make it a one-on-one matchup. Other guys, they just defeat everything in front of them. To get 2 sacks in a game, it's a little bit of both for you.
To throw. Buying time to his left. Now he'll let it go deep left side. And this is caught inside the 5. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
I know they had good coverage downfield, but you have to wonder, on 3rd and long like that, how does that happen that they can get that far downfield and complete a pass? You got to guard the sticks, understand where you are, so it's almost like someone fell asleep at the switch, and now that the play's been completed, they've got to dust themselves off on defense, pick it up, and figure out how to not let that happen again.
And now a 1st down following that long gain.
Detroit! Detroit! All right, here we go. Gun! Gun!
And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage, back at the 6. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
They'll look to throw, and a hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Six plays got him down here. This is play number seven, third and goal.
Here we go now. 3-19. Good, good.
They'll drop the throw. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And they'll be down just outside of the end zone at the one-yard line.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
2 seconds to go, first quarter. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon as it's London football to begin quarter number two. They've got a second down and 8 to start things out. Short gain here as he gets it up only to about the 6. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Now back to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Well, the fans should be applauding this defense right now. It's an excellent job. They force a 3-and-out, and they should be able to set up their guys with great field position, probably near midfield or better.
So they bring out their punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And where will this be spotted? The side judge says it went out just across midfield. Now this offense about ready to take over again. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
But how about going and telling your defense, thank you, a huge thank you. You said it didn't lead to points, stalled off that drive. Now they've got a chance to redeem themselves and maybe reward their defense a little bit by putting some points on the board on this one.
And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
Try the right side here. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
They'll look to throw now on first down. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down.
Hurry up, here we go. Watch it now, Barney.
Back to throw here. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
In motion, the tight end. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. They'll set up a throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 29. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
And to give this time to the tailback. Not much there. Maybe a couple up to the 35.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run. Just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, and you throw it again. Then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set them up.
Second down, and they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play, and that's going to make it third down and 10. And they'll send the tight end in motion here. On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's got green. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. And on now is the punter as he's on to kick it away. Kicks away as he angles this one for the sideline. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. And here now the offense heading back out there. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Oh, he can't hang on. That was a dream chance for any D lineman to possibly get a pick. But instead, it falls down.
People trying to say I'm on the enemy. Got a cold with my dogs, can't get in between. I can't give them life, no more energy. Amen, amen. It's
Spent about 60 on the time, I can't even lie. No way in, no way out, doubt, do or die. So I roll when I roll, must be, must be, must be, must be. Amen.